Hi guys, I'm Kasha. Welcome to the channel, to my wonderland. It is again a coffee time with me, and today I bring you more spooky recommendations. It is the time of the year that I like to dive into my horror because I do love horror. I love it all year long, but when October comes, I feel like now it's my time to let it all out. So today I bring you 5 spooky comic book recommendations. If you're looking for some cool horror comic books that you can devour this Halloween, I'm here for you. First, we have The Neonomicon by Alan Moore and Jason Burroughs. Let's not forget that Alan Moore crafted the real graphic novel concept, plus he redefined the idea of superheroes working also together with DC. And he gives us this jewel, which is basically taking all of the Lovecraftian horror. If you love Lovecraft, you're gonna adore this. And if you love the character of Cthulhu, you're going to love this. I myself got a copy of this recently as well, and I'm going to be rereading it for this October month. We only got 4 issues, but this is like the compilation of the 4 issues in one. And check it out, it is so cool. I just really love this. It says here that we're following the story of 2 young and cocky FBI agents that investigate a fresh series of ritual murders. And basically it's the story of them investigating these murders, and it is one of the darkest stories from Alan Moore. Next we have 30 Days of Night. I got my copies while I was still living in Spain, so they're probably still there, but this is one of my favorite ones. It was also taken into the big screen, and the movie is just fantastic. I think it's a very underrated movie, and yes, it is about vampires. The book is by Steve Mills and Ben Templesmith. One of the things that I enjoy the most about this comic, it is how the blood really comes to shine in these comic books. We're in Barrow, Alaska, and here we have 30 days in winter where it's only night. That is just like the perfect place to make a vampire story, which is what we get here. And I tell you, this is fantastic. And Steve Mills is one of the best narrators of modern horror in comics, and you should definitely check this out if you love vampire stories. Then we have Outcast by Robert Kirkman and Paul Azazeta. I hope I pronounced that right. And it is basically a series kind of that has been compared to The Walking Dead, but it couldn't be more different. After a life being plagued by demons, this guy decides to cut off himself from society, and he became, so to say, an outcast. It is full of creepy demons, and it has also a lot of really genuinely good scares. Then we have The Chilling Adventures of Sabrina, and yes, it is the comics where the new Netflix series is based from. It is by Roberto Aguirre Sacasa and by Robert Hack. It is considered to be kind of a spin-off from Afterlife with Archie. The story is based on the 1960s, but it has a lot of cool homages to the horror and supernatural. We follow our teenage witch, Sabrina Spellman, and her struggles to balance her life between being a human and a witch. And she has to face horrors from hell itself. You might know the TV series Sabrina the Witch, but that was not dark at all. The comics are the real Dark Sabrina the Witch. Now, I would love to include Stephen King here. You know I love spooky stories from Stephen King, but you also know that Stephen King did not really do comics, except the comics that are based on his books. But I found a solution to this, because we have Lock and Key by Joe Hill and Gabriel Rodriguez. Now, maybe the name Joe Hill might not say much to you, but he is Stephen King's son. He decided not to use the surname King on his books. I guess he just wanted to get his own path on the book industry without having to use his father's name. It is a modern horror classic story. The story is centered around a haunted mansion that we find in New England, and also about the family that lives in there. The best part about these comics is the crafted mythology about the keys. We have these magical keys that are actually made by demonic metal, and it is a really cool book. And the comics are really awesome. It's not just some standard horror. I really think that this is really like scary, spooky, and really, really good build world. And I recommend it to anybody that loves stories about haunted mansions. So these were my 5 spooky comic book recommendations for you to read this October or any other time. Anytime is good for horror. For horror and coffee. That's 2 things you can never have enough of. Are you planning on reading any horror comic books this October, or do you know any other cool horror comic books? Let me know down below. Remember to give the video a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, all my other social medias listed down below, and I hope to see you all guys in the next coffee time. Bye!